Hello everyone, my name is Vatsal and welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how as an Indian retail investor, you should be investing in the US stock markets. I'll broadly lay out four or five reasons why I think you should definitely be investing in and what are the risks of investing in the US stock markets. And towards the end, I'll also talk a little bit about how actually you can practically implement and invest in the US stock markets. So the number one reason why you should be investing in the US markets, and I think this is a very underappreciated point, is because the dollar rupee depreciation dynamics have historically been such that you'll always get a 2-3%, at least a 2-3% return every year just by investing and holding the dollar as an asset. So the idea is when you are investing in US stocks, you're basically holding the stocks in dollars. And historically the data has shown that you will have a 2-3% return just by holding dollars. And another reason why I think that factors into this is not just the weakness of the rupee, but the strength of the dollar in general. The dollar is the reserve currency of the world. And given current economic dynamics, given the aggressive monetary and fiscal stimulus in the US, the US dollar is going to be pretty strong and is going to remain the reserve currency of the world. So that's the number one reason why I think you should be investing from a safety point of view in the US markets. Secondly, I feel that, and this is again empirically proven by the data, that the S&P 500 or the NASDAQ has conventionally outperformed the Nifty or the Sensex by again another 2-3%. So 2-3% due to the depreciation and another 2-3% because of the outperformance ensures you're already earning 6-7% by investing in the US stock markets. Another thing that's very characteristic of the US markets, which I've noticed since I've stayed here for about 1.5 to 2 years and since I've been tracking markets, is that because the US financial system is so developed and has so many participants from different perspectives, right? You have dealers, you have brokers, you have retail investors, institutional investors. The US markets are very liquid, and as a consequence, they're extremely non-volatile. So the Sensex or the Nifty is typically more volatile than what the S&P 500 is. So that means you're having a lower standard deviation, a lower risk for each percentage of return that you'll earn, which means lesser volatility, better for investors. Now, the third reason why you should invest in the US stock markets is diversification. Now, I know a lot of people, including the great Peter Lynch, the great Warren Buffett, and Mark Cuban have also said that diversification is for idiots. But at the end of the day, we're just trying to earn good returns and minimize risk. And diversification plays a very key role in that. So if you have, say, 70 or 80% of your assets in the Indian stock markets and about 20-25% in the US stock markets, it kind of ensures that you're diversified and you're safe, and you're basically betting on two economies. One is an emerging market that's growing very fast, which is India, and the other is the US stock market. So diversification will help you immensely. Now, these are the more, I'd say, the macro reasons or the more safe or, you know, the internal feel good reasons, you know, but there are very particular and prominent reasons also why you should invest in the stock market, right? Number one being that the kind of stocks that you get in the US stock market, the kind of companies you have the opportunity to invest in is just insane. And I'm not talking here about the conventional FANG stocks, right? Like, I'm not talking about Facebook, Netflix, Google, Amazon, Apple, and so on and so forth, because everybody knows that, everybody can invest in that. They're omnipresent, they're all popular stocks. But the US stock market has so many other good stocks which are so deeply undervalued and which has such high growth run rates that if you have the knowledge of investing in these stocks, which are very high growth, low debt, high return on capital employed, high market share, you are really going to make a lot of money over and above what you're earning in depreciation and over and above what the index is already going to provide you with. So there are such insane stocks in the US market, and such cutting edge sort of stocks, right? And I'm not just talking about like the hyper artificial intelligence and machine learning stocks, but also stocks in very niche industries like network securities or insurance plays, or in big data and how governments can use software and corporations can use software to improve their services. These kind of companies are not there in India, and understandably, I think probably the only serious technology play in India today is Tata Elxsi, Hexaware Technologies, and the big IT companies, right? And probably a few other here and there, like InfoEdge, which I may have missed out. But in the US, you have stocks from each sector of the economy, and you have stocks which have such amazing runways and are backed by such big people that you really cannot afford to miss out on them if you want to make big money. If you want to make your conventional 14-15%, you needn't like really invest in the US stock market. But if you're looking at something like 20-25%, 30%, or doubling or tripling your money in 2 or 3 years, I think the US stock market really provides extremely good avenues over there. Now, let me talk about some risks in like investing in the US stock market, right? The first is that there are transaction costs, there are exchange rate costs, and the brokerage sort of, it's more complicated, it's more mentally straining to go through the process and do it. But I think compared to the kind of returns you'll be earning, the kind of safety diversification you'll be having, this is just a very, it's like a minor ant bite, to be honest. Like, it does not really matter in the longer scheme of things. And the second risk, of course, is how do you, as an Indian investor sitting back home in India, sitting in Delhi, Mumbai, Kanpur, Lucknow, Kolkata, Chennai, wherever, Bangalore, wherever, how do you know which stocks to invest in? Because in India, the bigger brokerages, they keep publishing like which stocks are good, like, oh, you have your Asian Paints, Bajaj Finance, where you can invest in. But how do you know which particular stocks in the US over and above the FANG stocks or the JP Morgans or the Goldman Sachs should you invest in? And that is where I feel someone like me can play a really big role, because I've been here in the US. I myself personally invest in the US stock markets, and I have a good knowledge of what stocks you can really invest in. And that'll be a big endeavor of my channel, to provide you guys with exactly that sort of expertise, where you can just watch a YouTube video, watch a 15-20 minute YouTube video, and understand like which stock is really good to invest in. So I feel that is where people like me can really fill in the gap and provide that expert knowledge and provide that confidence, really, that you as an investor would obviously seek. Another thing, one sort of ancillary reason why you can also invest in the US stock markets is the reason that it's extremely safe. The investor regulations, the investor protections, the market manipulations in the US stock markets are much lesser compared to obviously what they are for emerging markets. So considering all these reasons, I think there is absolutely no reason why you should not invest in the US markets. There's absolutely many reasons why you should diversify, why you can return, you can get higher returns. And in another video, I'll be exactly telling you all how can you go about practically investing in the US stock markets. What documents do you need? What brokers do you need to contact? How should you contact them? What are like the exchange rate sort of things? These are not complicated, okay? Like, you, if you have the zeal and the curiosity and the hunger to like earn those returns, you'll figure these things out at the site. So I'll post another video where I'll be talking about how you can invest practically in the US stock markets. So thank you so much. If you've watched the video till the very end, I would also urge you to subscribe to my channel. And also, more importantly than subscribing, is provide feedback to me and tell me what sort of content would you like. How can I tailor my videos better? And just generally any feedback. I read all your comments, and I look forward to making more videos like this. Until then, stay tuned and happy investing.